Elections, big name earnings, and crucial data will grab eyeballs next week. First to India, where parliamentary elections kick off on Monday. Investors will have to be patient, though. The mammoth exercise has 9 phases, and a new prime minister probably won't be announced till May. The politically hardline but pro-business Narendra Modi of the opposition BJP party is the frontrunner and the candidate markets are rooting for. We also get crucial data for March from Asia's economic powerhouse, China. Let's listen to what one market watcher is expecting.
Well, I think that what we should generally see in terms of the trade data is a little bit of recovery in terms of Chinese exports. On the import side, we may see an increase in the imports too, principally because some of the stimulus packages are geared towards higher levels of investments. One of the great uncertainties about China trade figures has been the mixing of the trade figures with the capital flow data. I think we should actually see less short-term capital flow data coming through, or less short-term capital flows coming through because of the decline in the currency.
On Tuesday, we go to South Korea, where the world's biggest technology firm by revenue, Samsung Electronics, will provide guidance on its first quarter earnings. With investors fretting about a slowdown in its key smartphone division, the tech titan has warned that it will be tough to improve results in the first quarter due to weak seasonal demand. In the previous quarter, Samsung posted its first quarterly profit decline in 2 years because of slowing smartphone sales and a stronger won currency.